It's simple mathematics. Check it out. I'll evolve around science.
What are we talking about here?
What's up, everybody? It's your boy Jacob, also known as Pick Management, back here with the Prince of Picks, my guy Payam, for another episode of the NBA Betting Insiders. It was a rough night for us. We are full disclosure here. It was a little tough. I went 3-4. Payam went 4-6. Had some wins, had some losses. Could have been better, but it could have been worse. So we are back to rebound for the Tuesday slate. Payam, ready to rebound?
I am ready to rebound. Like you said, yeah, a bit of a rough night, but a silver lining here. My dog did hit, so I had Memphis on the money line at plus 350, and they won outright. So that was my replacement dog because of the injuries that came with the Giannis injury for the Bucks and Clippers. So I had to quickly find a replacement dog. I found it, and it hit. So that's four dogs in a row. So I'm on a roll in terms of my underdogs, and I'm looking to make it five in a row tonight. So. But yeah, man, ready to get back into it tonight, get back on the winning ways here.
All right. Well, before we get started, I got to let you guys know you need to check out a couple of things that you need to add to your toolbox as a bettor. You need to check out the Juice WRLD app. Juice WRLD is a totally free app that automatically syncs to your sports books and gives you insights and analytics into how you wager so you can become a better bettor. The other thing you need to do is download the Rhythm app. Rhythm is also another totally free app that teaches you how to build models and algorithms for sports betting. It fast tracks you. Don't spend the time and money on learning how to be a statistician. Take the shortcut. Use Rhythm. The link is below. Make sure to check it out. You guys can build models just like Mark from the hockey show, whose model is hitting at 70% the last 90 days. Otherwise, we are going to jump right into this Tuesday slate. So, Payam, hit me with your best bets.
Yep, absolutely. All right, we're going to start off with a 7 p.m. Eastern tip. But the Orlando Magic are traveling to Charlotte to take on the Charlotte Hornets. Some trends for this one. Charlotte comes into this one 29th in the league in scoring. Meanwhile, Orlando, they are fifth in scoring defense. So they allow the fifth least amount of points in the league to opponents. So for those of you here, I'm on Charlotte. Team total under 99.5. I don't think they break 100 here. Charlotte's one of the worst teams in the league, not to mention statistically one of the worst bottom two teams in scoring in the league. So Orlando has held their opponent to under 100 points in two of their last three overall. And also Charlotte has scored under 100 points in four of their last six overall here. So all the trends, all the recent trends, statistics here are suggesting that Charlotte's going to have a rough time against this Orlando team. So I'm all over the Charlotte team total under 99.5. And I'm also going to be taking Orlando -8.5 here at -110. Orlando, they are 78% ATS as a favorite. Charlotte, they're just 36% ATS versus the Eastern Conference this season. Their last matchup, Orlando did win that one by 13. And I expect that to happen again tonight. I expect a double-digit win here by Orlando. I know Orlando has had their issues on the road, but there's a few spots here where you can kind of ignore that trend. Charlotte is one of those teams because, Charlotte really doesn't have much of a home court advantage because they don't have much of a team. So I'm all over Orlando here. I think they get the job done here by double digits. Anything for you on this?
Yeah, I'm actually going to take the Magic team total over here. I know that they haven't been scoring a whole ton of points, and Charlotte games have tended to be lower scoring, but 108.5 is really low here. Yeah. And I'm just taking this because I think, there's not really much trends backing it up right now, but Orlando can score points, and Charlotte's defensively is just bad, really bad. And regardless if this is a low-scoring game, like I think it's going to be, I think Orlando could put up over 108 in their sleep. So I'm going to take their team total over here.
Yeah, the funny thing is Charlotte can legitimately give up 140 to any team on any given night, right? So, their team there is that bad. So, yep, can't go wrong with that. Next up, 7:30 p.m. Eastern tip, where the Cleveland Cavaliers are going to be hosting the Boston Celtics. Boston, they're coming off of that 52-point win versus the Golden State Warriors the other night. And I think this is a good opportunity for a letdown spot here against a feisty and gritty Cavs team in Cleveland. I get it, Donovan Mitchell's not playing, but I don't think it's going to make it'll make a difference, but I think they can still keep it competitive here with the Boston team. Boston has been known to have some letdown spots here, especially after big wins. Sometimes their maturity is in question. And sometimes they can, against teams that they should handle, they kind of play with their food a little bit here and screw around until maybe the late third, fourth quarter, and then they try to pull away. So I expect this game to be relatively close. I think there's a good opportunity for that. Cleveland has a lot to play for here too. So, just because Mitchell's not there You know, they're right in the thick of the playoff hunt here. They're fighting for a seeding position. And at home, that place is, you know, a pretty tough environment. And you know, Cleveland knows what Boston's been doing. The fans know what Boston's been doing. It's a rivalry. So, I love Cleveland here. I think it's a good spot for them. So plus 9.5 is what I'm going to take it at. I got that at minus 150. I did buy it up a little bit. I saw it at plus 8 last night. So, as you guys know, I did my research the night before. So, I bought it up to plus 9.5. Celtics, they're 2-0 on the money line versus the Cavs this season. However, both wins were just by single digits, and both wins were in Boston. So this is their first matchup in Cleveland here for the season. So, yeah, I think a lot of trends here, suggest that Cleveland might keep this close. So plus 9.5, that's going to be my official play for this one. You got anything?
Yeah. So if Porzingis, do you know, so he was on the injury report on Sunday as questionable. Do you know if he's playing today? Jaylen Brown and Porzingis are both questionable for today. So if I would say if both of them don't play, this is going to be a no play for me. If one of them plays, one doesn't, I think I'll still ride with it. But Boston is like one of the top two, three teams in adjusted offense in the league. I get the Cavs are playing better, but with the Donovan Mitchell out, I just don't think that they will be able to slow down this Boston team. And their team total is only 112.5. I get that they're on the road. And that Cleveland is like a better defensive team that they've been facing, but Boston's been putting up crazy points. They've covered this number in the last 5 games, and Cleveland has allowed this team total to hit in 4 out of their last 5 games. So Cleveland is giving up over 112.5. I just think that is way too low. I might be smashing this with a couple of units. Honestly, I really like this team total over here. Check the socials later to make sure exactly how much I'm putting on it. But this Boston Celtics team total is going to be a smash spot.
Yeah, if anything, I might lean towards the over here if Porzingis and Brown do play. So
yeah, I like the game over too. I do. I didn't mean to cut you off, but no, game total over two. I think even with the Mitchell injury, Cleveland still has some pieces to be able to put up some points. I think they can eclipse 100 and do their part to hit the total.
Absolutely, right there with you. Okay, next up, another 7:30 p.m. Eastern tip, where the Miami Heat are going to be hosting the Detroit Pistons. Miami, they're just 41% ATS at home this season. This is a team that really struggles to cover the spread at home. Meanwhile, Detroit, they're actually 52% ATS on the road. So that means they've obviously covered more than they haven't. And for those reasons here, you know, I like Detroit. I think Detroit is playing better. I think they're a hungry team. They're playing, you know, Monty's got them playing a little bit harder. They're playing with more energy. I think their pieces are starting to fit together a little bit better. I mean, they got a ways to go, but I guess a Miami team that goes through scoring droughts at times and just really has a hard time covering the ATS at home here in general. Getting 11.5 with Detroit here, I'll take the points here. So Detroit plus 11.5, minus 120. I do think they can keep it within, you know, single digits here. Their last matchup was actually the first game of the season. Miami won that by 1 point. So, I know it was the first game of the season, but, you know, relatively the same teams. Minus a few pieces here and there, but yeah, I think Detroit can you know, at least keep it somewhat competitive here with Miami. So 11.5 plus 11.5 Detroit, that's my play for this one. Anything for you?
Nothing for me on this one. I was taking a peek at Adebayo and Butler points and rebounds over. Nothing official for me yet. I want to see this Detroit lineup. I know they don't have too many injuries. I know that they've taken down Miami once, but I don't know. Miami at home can be tough. So check the socials later. Nothing official though.
Okay, for sure. Yep. All right. Next up, there's a lot of 7:30 p.m. Eastern tips here. So another 7:30 p.m. Eastern tip. The Toronto Raptors are hosting the New Orleans Pelicans. Pelicans come to this one with a 3-day rest. And after this game, they'll have another 2 days off. So that means they're only going to be playing one game in 6 days, which is really rare considering in an NBA schedule. But somehow that worked out for them. So I think they're going to play with maximum effort tonight because there's really no reason not to. I mean, they're not, you know, they're well-rested and they'll be well-rested after. So one game, 6 days, why not, you know? And the Raptors, you know, they got a lot of injuries to a lot of key players here. So this team is banged up and they're in full tank mode now. And I think the Raptors are going to really start to unravel here towards the end of the season. They just have too many injuries. They've lost too many pieces. And, you know, it's going to be really hard for them to be competitive here. I think they could be one of the bottom 3-4 teams in the NBA here going down the stretch of the season. So I love New Orleans' defense here to hold Toronto under 110.5. So I'm going Toronto team total under 110.5 here at minus 125. New Orleans comes into this one with the number 8 ranked defense in the league. Meanwhile, Toronto was a bottom 12 team offensively, and that's overall for the whole season. So like we just said here, you know, or like I just said, you know, with all the injuries here, all the missing pieces, you know, those stats are probably skewed positively for Toronto. I think they're even worse than that offensively. So, yeah, I think Toronto struggles here offensively. So I'm all over the team total under 110.5 for Toronto. Did you have anything for your
Pelicans? Oh, yeah. I love the Pelicans. You know, I don't really have like a favorite team.
You got Zion points and rebounds?
Yeah, no. Not Zion points and rebounds. I'm taking Pelicans -7. I bought it down a little bit. And I'm taking their team total over. With the amount of rest that they have, I think that they're going to come out here energized. I like the first half over as well. First half over 112. Actually, let me see if I get that up to a little lower. I'll take it at 111. First half over 111. I think we can get there for sure. I think maybe we can see like a 65-50 first half. So mark that down just in case I hit that correct score. But yeah, I really think the Pelicans are just going to blow out this Toronto team. Toronto's been playing a lot of games recently. And with honestly, just so much rest. I mean, like a whole week off is just crazy.
It's crazy. Like another all-star break for them almost.
Yeah, right. And Toronto just played 2 days ago. This is their fourth game in 6 days. I mean, it's just a lot of basketball against this, you know, jazzed up Pelicans team. So let's ride with this Pelicans -7 and team total over.
Cool. Love it. All right. Next up, another 7:30 p.m. Eastern tip. With the Philadelphia 76ers are headed to Brooklyn to take on the Nets. Now, this one, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm a little scared of it. It's a little scary, but let me give you some trends here. It makes you feel better. Brooklyn, 2-7 on the money line on back-to-backs this season. Brooklyn have also, this will be their fifth game in 7 days. So we're talking about the complete opposite of what we were just talking about with the Pelicans here. This team has to be tired. There's no way around it. And, you know, Philly, they're also coming off of a big win against Dallas a couple nights ago. That was in Dallas, actually. And they've actually won 2 in a row and 3 of their last 5. So there are some trends here to suggest that maybe, just maybe, Philly might be trying to turn a corner here without Embiid. I'm still not fully invested in them without Embiid, but I am even more so not invested in the Brooklyn Nets. This is more of a play against Brooklyn than it is for Philly, just because I think Brooklyn is just completely broken right now. You know, I don't know what it's really hard to say what's going on with them, because you look at their roster, and they shouldn't be playing as bad as they have. My God, this team is just playing like complete ass. I mean, they just lost to Memphis, of all teams, like at home. You know, Memphis with a bunch of G League players is just manhandling this team. You know, and it's really shocking to see, quite honestly. Side note here, you know, I got a lot of love for Mikal Bridges and Cam Johnson. They were a big part of my Phoenix Suns team when we made that finals run in 2021. They were, you know, integral parts of that team. And, you know, I was sad to see them go when they left Phoenix. You know, granted, we didn't get Kevin Durant back, so it wasn't that bad of a, you know, I missed them a little bit, but not too much. But, you know, I really respect them as players, but it's sad to see what they're kind of going through right now in this. With this Brooklyn team, you know, I heard on another podcast, someone described the Nets as a collection of players that act like they don't want to be there. And I think that's a perfect way to put it, because you see their effort level on a night-to-night basis, and it's just not there. So for all those reasons here, I'm on Philly moneyline, -142. You know, not to mention, you know, 8 of the last 10 losses for Brooklyn has been by double digits. So not only are they losing games, they're getting blown out. Again, so that, you know, I like Philly here. I think they're trending, you know, slightly in the right direction. But you know, against this Brooklyn Nets team, I think they can get the job done here and win it outright. So,
yeah, I love that. I'm taking Philly here too. Just as, like you said, this is a bet against Brooklyn than more bet on Philly. I think Philly still has the pieces to be dominant somewhat when they want to be. And the Nets on back to back, 2-6-1, not very good. You know, the fact that Ben Simmons is like one of their best players makes me be like, oh, the Nets, you know what I mean?
That says it all, Jacob. Honestly, the Ben Simmons is the face of your franchise.
Yeah,
this is what you get.
Yeah, exactly. And he's questionable tonight, so he's always questionable, but whatever. I think, and you know what, tomorrow is 4 weeks for Embiid, so he is supposed to be checked out between 4 and 6 weeks. So if they wanted to give him some motivation to come back, they need to start winning. All over this Philly money line.
Cool. All right. And then the final play for me tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern tip, the San Antonio Spurs are making the short trip to Houston to take on the Rockets in the interstate Texas rivalry here. I'm not taking a side here just because, honestly, I really don't trust either team. They're both pretty inconsistent. I know Houston's better at home than they are on the road, but they've still been known to lay some eggs here and there at home. And San Antonio, I never know what I'm going to get from them from a night-to-night basis. So I'll stay away from the spread, but I am going to take a player prop here. I am on Victor Wembanyama over 3.5 blocks at -125. This dude is an absolute block machine. He has had 4+ blocks in 7 of his last 8 games overall. You know, in Houston, they're actually 28th in the league in 3-point percentage. So what does that mean? That means they're going to have a lot of, they shoot a lot of mid-range shots, and they shoot a lot of dribble drive shots towards the, you know, to get to the lane and get some layups and dunks and whatnot. So that means a lot more opportunities for Wembanyama here to get blocks. You know, when you got a team that doesn't like to shoot the three, or they don't shoot the three very well, you know, the closer you get to the hoop, the easier it is to block a shot. So for all those reasons here, you know, statistically and just schematically, I like Victor Wembanyama over 3.5 blocks, -125. I know this is kind of a tricky game. Did you have anything for this one?
Yeah, trying to. My dog's barking. Sorry.
Did Bruno have anything for this one?
No, Bruno doesn't have anything for this one. Okay. It's Kupo. Kupo is the other one. Kupo. You haven't seen Kupo yet. Sorry, just totally broke my whole train of thought. Nothing for me here on this one. I did have a couple more plays, though. I'm going to take this Mavericks team. I'm going to take them on the money line. And I'm going to take their team total over 124.5. We've seen this Pacers team get a little bit better defensively and then crash back down to earth and give up a ton of points here. I think that Dallas, who has lost their last 2 games and 4 out of their last 5, is looking for a win here. And I think that this Indy team is a spot for them to get it. They have a day off. They didn't play last night. Neither of them did. So I think we see a high scoring shootout in this one. You know, Mavericks games haven't been super high scoring lately, but I think this one might get up there. Actually, you know, their games have been kind of high scoring. 236, 248, 251, 240, 244. So these games have been kind of high scoring. So I might be looking at this game total over. Check the socials, but I'm definitely on Mavericks team total over and their money line.
Yeah, Pacers are a roller coaster defensively. Like you said, you know, they're up and down. But yeah, going to Dallas is, you know, they're really good at home. And they like to put up a lot of points. So yeah, I'm with you. I think there's a ton of points. I think it's a shootout tonight. And I also think Luka might go off. So stay tuned to the socials here. Once, you know, some more player props and injury reports come out, I might be posting that as another play here. Luka, I think he's in for a big night tonight.
Yep. All right. Well, you want to recap your plays?
Yeah, let me go ahead and do that. So I'm on, for the Magic Hornets, I'm on Charlotte team total under 99.5. I'm also going to be on Orlando -8.5. I am on Cleveland +9.5 versus the Celtics. I am on Detroit +11.5 versus the Heat. I am on Toronto team total under 110.5 versus the Pelicans. I'm going to be taking Philadelphia money line against the Brooklyn Nets. And for the Spurs Rockets game, I am on Victor Wembanyama over 3.5 blocks.
Excellent. Where can people find you?
You guys can find me on X and on Twitter. I'm sorry, X and TikTok at Prince of Picks. X, Twitter, TikTok at Prince of Picks 10. Also, make sure to follow us on the Discord app here, Pick Management Podcast Network Discord, where I will be posting my NBA Money Line Parlay of the day. And Jacob, you got something? I'm gonna give my dog of the day. But what do these people need to do in order to get that?
Yeah, we need 20 likes again on this video. To get the dog of the day. We appreciate it. We hit it yesterday, and we got like 40 more views than we usually do. So we appreciate all the new viewers. Make sure you guys stick around. Hit that like, hit that subscribe so you never miss an episode of the NBA Betting Insiders, the NHL Betting Insiders, Betting the Pitch Europe and Champions League, and we also have the MLS Betting Insiders, which has really been blowing up. That's the
real quick, just so you guys know, I've hit 4 dogs in a row.
Yeah, four dogs in a row. That is serious.
More of a center for you guys to really get these likes up so I can share that with you guys.
Yeah, but we have to start laddering that. We have to start rolling those over.
Yeah.
Well, let me recap my plays real quick. I am on Magic team total over 108.5, Boston team total over 112.5, New Orleans -7, New Orleans team total over 119.5, Philly money line, Dallas money line, and Dallas team total over 124.5. Before we go, I got to let everyone know it is my wedding anniversary. So happy anniversary to my lovely wife who creates all of our wonderful layouts and graphics for all these shows. She does a killer job and it's been a wonderful 4 years. And here's to 400 more. But if you guys want more stuff and better tools for your betting toolbox, check out the apps I mentioned earlier. Juice Reel, only free app that automatically syncs to your sports book and provides insights and analytics into how you wager so you can become a better bettor, or you can track some of the most successful bettors on the app. Guy on there has bet $80 million in the last year, and he crushes every single day. You can find that on Juice Reel. And if you want to learn how to build models and algorithms in sports betting to be a real statistician and, you know, upgrade yourself to, you know, a real analytical guy, take the shortcut, sign up for Rhythm. It's totally free. They teach you how to build models and algorithms. They have pre-built ones you can play around with and alter to yourself. So make sure you guys check out Juice Reel and Rhythm. Apps are below, and I'm sorry, links are below. Make sure you sign up for the Pick Management Discord, extra bonus plays, videos, all that stuff from the whole Pick Management team. This has been the NBA Betting Insiders. I'm Jacob at Pick Management across all socials. We will see you later. It's simple mathematics. Check it out.